Hi viewers, welcome back to the weekly video. So if you look at the Nifty, last week has corrected from the highs of around 11,794-11,800 levels. And even if you look at the global markets, most of the global markets were down by around 1.5%. And the only exception was Nikkei, which ended flat to positive territory. But even if you look at the major indices globally, they were down around 1.4-1.5%. And even if you look at the sectoral index into the US and India, most of the indices ended into the red territory. Even if you look at the bank Nifty in the last week session, though the last week of the August expiry, they gained nearly 10% outperforming the Nifty. And just to remember that the chart which we have shared before in the previous video, bank Nifty to Nifty chart, we clearly indicated that Nifty is about to underperform and bank Nifty is about to outperform over the Nifty. And we have seen those strong 10% rally into the index. And when we have alerted, it was around 1.94 the ratio, the bank Nifty to Nifty, which has moved to back to 2.07. Again, a strong stellar performance by bank Nifty. But if you look at the last week, the momentum, bank Nifty underperformed, and we have seen that bank Nifty down by 6%, whereas Nifty was down by around 1.5-2%. So overall, if you look at the Monday, the last Monday, where market opened on the gap up positive and ended in the red zone. So let's look at the Nifty structure and what we feel. We feel that Nifty, a short-term top is in place, and 3-4 reasons why we feel technically that the structure is a short-term top. First, let's look at the weekly chart on your screen. And if I just look at the weekly chart, it is forming bearish harmonic. So basically, the bearish harmonic are the pattern which are calculated based on the Fibonacci. And if you look at the bearish bet, it's basically 88.6% of XA. So if you look at the screen, right from 12,400 levels back to 7,500 levels, and if I just take 88.6%, it stood out to be at around 11,800 levels, 11,780 precisely if I just look at. And if you look at the recent high, 11,790. Secondly, if I just look at this time wise, the structure XAB, so basically harmonic time cycle are formed at, when you look at the XAB triangle, so on your screen if you look at the XAB, it took around 14 weeks. And if I just look at the BCD, which is a triangle, second triangle on the right side, if you look at the structure has formed around 18 weeks. If I just look at the FIB time, which is the Fibonacci time, and if I just multiply 1.27, which is 127% of the 14 days or 14 weeks, it turns out to be around 18 weeks. So with the price structure forming the harmonic pattern, with the price time forming the Fibonacci time reversal, we think that the short-term top is in place for Nifty. And if I just look at the daily chart on your screen, look at the daily chart, it is forming negative divergence on RSI. Second thing, if you look at the bearish engulfing structure, bearish engulfing structure is visible on the Nifty, where on the last Monday, if you look at the open, it opened at around 11,790 and in the end ended on a negative red, forming a bearish engulfing. And the same structure we have seen when market has formed the high of around 12,490. And remember, we are not looking at those fall, though it was one of the pandemic issue and the fall was severe, but we are not expecting those fast and furious fall on the negative side on the Nifty. But if I just look at the structure, yes, we are expecting a break of 11,000 on Nifty in the short term. So probably we are looking at 10,800 on the downside on the Nifty and in the short term time. So any rise toward 11,430, 11,500 could be a good short opportunity, keeping a stop loss of 11,800 on the upside and look for target of 10,800 on the downside. One can also look for puts on the downside if you want to look for low risk reward trades. Thank you.